is in making a game, and there's lots of experimentation, and
right up until the point where it's burnt on a disc, every decision is critiqued.
I don't think it's necessary.
Even more,
it's the big door that comes
brings up that other grenade.
On through all the tribulations, it's a much more harrowing process than I think most of the fans understand.
Everybody has a different opinion on what drives Halo. It's the art. It's environments. It's the graphics. And the most important part to me is story.
Whether it's a love story between the Chief and Cortana or an action-packed explosion fest, and how we get our stories in there.
We went through a full year of pre-production on this project. The story is one of the first things we sit down and talk about when we go to create a game.
And if the Chief just has head sort of like reaction to what, you know.
Stories are always created the same way. First off, a group of people agreed that this is the story that we want to tell.
What's gonna happen to the Chief? What's gonna happen to Cortana? We had been working on this story nonstop, making compromise after compromise because there were a lot of things that different people didn't agree on.
Dude, the story should be about Earth getting destroyed, or let's show the Chief's face. That'd be a really good idea.
Radio for VTOL. Heavy lift gear.
We write the first draft of the script, but it's not great. Man, do I really want to give all this credit to Marty?
I didn't see any shape to this story. Nothing happy, nothing sad, nothing intense.
But a premature firing will destroy the arc.
It's like, I think it needs more punch.
Unacceptable! Unacceptable!
What it really needs is some death.
You actually want to get to the point where the player goes, well, wait a minute, I've been this character for 3 games. They can't possibly kill me.
By having the reality of death a part of the story, it did actually introduce this tone of heroism.
Johnson, sound off.
There's no sense of heroic action if there's no real consequences.
Get out of here!
Something that's really important is that our characters feel real.
Do it.
Is Miranda coming across as strong enough?
Now!
Does the Arbiter have enough vengeance built up in him to really push that sword into truth?
You must be silenced. Ah!
But the story that we're telling is the story of a human conflict with an aggressive adversarial species, the Covenant.
One of the keys to the success of the story is we didn't pump a lot of time into figuring out who the Master Chief was and why he was a ghost in the shell. We thought he is a husk. He's a big green suit of armor that you move around.
There's something good about having the Master Chief essentially be a blank slate. That helps each individual person connect to the character.
You found me. But so much of me is wrong.
The main personal relationship you have in the game is with an AI called Cortana.
I do know how to pick them.
At least one of our writers refers to her as your girlfriend.
Cortana's every girlfriend that we've ever had. No, just kidding. She's your little guardian angel.
Got an escape plan?
Thought I'd try shooting my way out.
Cortana plays a huge role in the fiction of this game, and we didn't want people to forget about her.
No. I don't want to chance a remote detonation. I need to stay here.
By the end of Halo 2, the Chief is separated from Cortana for the first time.
After I'm through with truth.
You'll make a girl a promise.
If you know you can't keep it.
You need to constantly remind players of what they're missing, that this thing is something worth going after. But if it was just a straight, now go find her, here's a map, people wouldn't care.
Chief, it's not safe. The Gravemind, it knows I'm in the system.
Having that moment where you actually see her with the Gravemind fighting for her existence, it was just a really powerful idea for us.
Hurry, Chief. The Ark. There isn't much time.
In Halo 3, we're obviously picking up where Halo 2 left off. The Covenant have occupied Earth. Humanity is sort of down to its last defenses.
The Elites and the Brutes are destroying everything that the Prophet of Truth doesn't.
All of the Halos are primed and ready to fire.
The Flood is out, and who knows where they're heading? An unstoppable, voracious parasite.
You have nothing going for you at the beginning of Halo 3, except for you.
This is as big as it gets.
In games, it's always this fundamental trade-off between immersion and drama.
Wait!
We really tried to create this nice, tight, woven mesh of fiction and gameplay.
It is a balance between telling the story and letting the player have their own story.
Is it more satisfying as a player to kill Guilty Spark yourself or to see the Chief do it in cinematic. But as soon as you make that decision, you're taking that action away from the player.
Figuring that out is really the challenge of telling stories in games.
When you're trying to balance story and gameplay, one can't come at the expense of the other.
The trick is to weave story into those gameplay sequences without interrupting the gameplay.
We're being a lot more cagey about the way we sneak story in.
There's the Cortana channel, there's the perspective channel, there's the letterbox channel, which are the traditional cinematics. All of those work together to tell our story across the entire game.
Perspective channel essentially means that Chief is still gonna be in the scene, but it's not a letterbox cinematic, but he's not gonna talk, and they're gonna be really short, and they're mainly just gonna focus on the action.
The event is happening in real time. When you press the skip it, instead of going to the end, that event just continues to happen.
It's just one of those little sort of exploratory moments that players can choose to take part in or they can choose to ignore.
It feels much more like a story that you're experiencing instead of a game with a movie that comes in every once in a while.
There are certain parts of the story that you tell by having Cortana talking in your ear.
It was the coin's fault. I wanted to make you strong.
The Cortana effect is essentially another story channel that we came up with. Because she is with the Flood, she can sort of give you bits and pieces of, you know, what's going on, but in this really fractured, fragmented sort of way. Your mission?
Could you watch me die?
We also have a separate storytelling method, which we call the vignettes. It's just a cool little thing where the characters are animated in a very custom way.
You can walk into an environment and you can see a couple brutes beating up a couple Marines.
They're not just standing there looking at the door that you just came through, pointing their weapons at you.
It gets the sense that there's something else greater going on in the story.
One of the things that we've tried really hard to do was make the cinematics directly related to what you just finished doing or what you're about to start doing. In Halo 3, almost all of our letterbox cinematics start with a player action.
You must activate.
So it flows really nicely from one gameplay segment into the cinematic and out to the other gameplay segment.
I'm sitting here, day in and day out, working on the cinematics. And every scene that I make, there's this voice in the back of my head saying, what is keeping the player from skipping this? What's keeping the player from hitting a button and just going right to the end?
Ultimately, it's involving the player and making the player really feel that they're in this story.
You want to establish that this is something a little bit more important.
The story that we're trying to tell has higher stakes. Whether we can do that, we won't know until that thing's in people's hands and they're playing.